Hey, what's up, you guys? So, for today's video, I'm going to be talking about thievery. Now, there's a lot of talk about of this because I've stole from a friend, I've stole from a store, I've had someone steal from me, I've seen someone steal, and I'm going to be telling you guys all those stories, which is not a very long story, so it's going to be kind of like a 6-minute video, let's say, unless I start getting off task and start talking about, I don't know. So, this was, I'm talking about my most recent, known to my past recent. So, this was about 6 years ago, and maybe five, and you guys know Angel, and Angel, I went over Angel's house, and she had this tattoo, and it was like maybe this size, had like a peace sign on it, and I went over her house with my friend Julia, we were helping her clean her room, or something like that. And we were in there, and she had the tattoo, and my friend picked it up and put it in her pocket. And yeah, and then Angel's like, oh, where'd the tattoo go? And I was like, I don't know. And then like a week later, I went over to Julia's house and she had the tattoo on. And then her parents found out that she took it, but they blamed it on me, which it wasn't me, but like, because it was in her pocket, it was on her body, you know. Don't blame me for it. I mean, it was kind of my idea. I was like, oh, look, a tattoo. And she's like, oh, we should take it. Like, remember, I was like 5 or 6 or 7, I don't know. But I know I was very young. I was not this age. I was 6. I want to say 6. So, finally, her parents did not trust me. They would not let me in Angel's room alone. They would not let me go anywhere alone in their house. Like, they thought I was going to steal something. For maybe 3 years. Like, I don't think, like, Angel still doesn't trust me to go in her room. And I'm not even joking. And then, Angel came over maybe a couple weeks later. And she's like, oh, I have tattoos on my floor. And she's like, oh, can I have a tattoo? And I'm like, sure. And she's like, yeah, because you took mine. And I'm like, oh my god. And I'm like, she doesn't talk like that, but you know, I'm just talking like that. And I was like, oh my lord. So then I was like, okay, does this make up for it? And she's like, no, you still stole something from me. I was like, but I just gave you 5. Doesn't make it up? And she's like, no. I'm like, of course it doesn't. So I gotta clean my room. I'm so excited for that. And then, yeah, so then I'm going to tell my next story of when I stole from a store. So this happened a few years ago, as I said, and I was at the dollar store with my mom. And we were just, like, buying whatever we needed around the house, just whatever. And we were there, and I had about $5 on me, maybe for my birthday, for Valentine's Day, I don't know. And I was walking around, and I saw something that I thought was kind of cute. It was like a clip. It came with a clip that you can clip in your hair and have like hair from it. And like I thought it was a wig, and it was not a wig. But whatever. Not talking about that right now. So my mom, I don't consider this stealing. I really don't. So my mom's calling. She called my dad, and she's like, "Hey, I need extra money." And he said, "Okay." He drives down, and my mom goes outside, and she gets the money. And I run outside the store, and my mom's like, did you pay for that? And I'm like, no. And she's like, get back in the store now. So I go in the store, and my mom's like, thank you so much for not calling the cops on her. And he's like, I said, okay. So that's a great story. It's actually not a great story. So I came home, and I clipped the thing in my hair, and it wasn't a wig. So my next story, wait, I said I was going to tell you a story. Someone stole from me, because that story was about maybe less than a year back. So I was raising money to give to an animal shelter because the animal shelter, helped me find my dog, my old dog. They helped me find him, like, they found him, and they were just a big help. So I was like, okay, so I'm to this place, really, really nice, and they're just, like, they really are in need of, like, money for animals and whatever, and food. It's ACT, and every time I went to the, down to an animal hospital to take my dog there, because he had to go to the hospital a lot, he was very sick, and when we were there, I would always buy stuff or get stuff for ACT. Like, you could get like a gigantic 20-pound bag of food, and I would get it, and I would give it to ACT, and I got like 3 of those bags, and I went shopping at Target, and I brought $20 with me, and I brought $35 with me. And my dad gave me 20, and he said, let's just say that's my donation. And I said, okay. So my dad gave me $20 to pay for all the dog food, some of the dog food. I bought a 10-pound bag of dog food, you know, stuff like that. And I donated that, and I donated $60. About, sorry, I'm sorry, I got off fast. And I got about $60. I asked my uncle, I asked my dad's friend, I asked my grandma, my mom, my dad, just everyone. Anyone, like, I don't care. I asked my neighbor, who I didn't even know. He lives, like, around the corner from me. I asked him, I don't even know him. And he's like, oh, well, I would have gave you money if I had my wallet. And I was like, dang it. So, there we go. And I had $60. And my friend, she... I'm not saying, I don't give her a name. I always use the name Ashley, so why not use Ashley? So, this girl, me and her, like, I don't know. I always liked Angel more than her, obviously, because me and Angel known each other for 7 years, or at that point, 5 or 6 years. And obviously, I would like Angel more because, well, Angel was more mature. This girl was 2 grades lower than me. And I'm not saying I don't like people that are younger than me. I'm not saying that at all. I'm just saying Angel was more mature and more fun to hang out with. But this girl was fun to hang out with. I'm not gonna lie. And basically, this girl came over, and Angel is the one person that I, like I said to my parents, that I know would never, ever, ever steal from me. Ever. So if Angel stole from me, then that would be, like, the biggest shock ever. Because Angel has never stole from me, never probably will, and I just completely trust Angel. I would let Angel take care of my dog more than anyone else in this world. Like, not gonna lie. Like, I'd rather her take care of my dog than my sister. Like, dead serious. So, she's taking, like, you know. So, Angel came over the day before, and the money was still there, and then, why did my parents take the money? Like, they know I was raising this for a good cause. Why did my parents take it? And, like, they don't need it. They have money. Like, what's the point? And then I went to the bathroom one day and I saw Kaylee always. I just said her name. Ashley was always kind of a suspicious person. Like, she would always, like, walk around and, like, look at things. Like, we were in my basement and she just stood there and, like, looked around like that. And it kind of creeped me out. And I don't care if she's watching us. Like, you know who you are because you know I accused you of this. No, I'll say her name. Her name is Callie, because I already said it. So, and then, Ashley is a lot easier to use, but her name's Callie, just letting you guys know. And, I'm going to say Ashley, because Ashley's a whole lot easier to say. Callie, I can't even say it anymore. I went to the bathroom, and I look, and I counted my money every single day to make sure that no one took it, because if that person came over, I knew they would have took it if it was gone. So, I looked after Angel came over, it was there. I looked every single day. I looked every single day. So, I looked when Kelly left. Why was there was a five missing, a five and a one, and I had like $60, and then I had like 54. Like, that was for a good cause. Like, and I even told her that was for an animal shelter, and she had to, like, go and take it. And I knew it was her because, like, do you know how much evidence I just had? Angel, if Angel stole from me, I would have never talked to her again because I trust her. Like I told you guys before, I trust Angel so, so much. Like, she's the one person in this world that I can tell everything to. Just. And don't even get me started. So, if Angel stole from me, like, I know it was not Angel. Like, she wasn't even on the radar. No, there was only one person on the radar, and that was Ashley. So, I'm not even gonna even with her. So, that girl, me and Ashley, don't talk anymore. Because she was talking about how Angel snuck out. And, like, her mom already knows about this. So, like, don't go and tell her parents because they already know. And Angel already told her parents, so, like... So, she was like, oh, we gotta tell her parents that she's not gonna... Oh, I don't think... No, it wasn't that. It was, like, something else. And, like, we gotta tell her parents that she's hanging out with this girl. And I'm like... Like, I was mad at Angel at the time. But, like, I always will love Angel. As, you know, as a sister. Like, she was like, oh, what's telling her? And I was, like, thinking about it because I was kind of mad at Angel. But I was like, no. And I saw Angel at the park. And I was like... And her friend that she wasn't allowed to hang out with. I walk up to both of them and I'm like, Callie just said that she's gonna tell your mom. And then her friend walked over and her friend started cursing her out. Angel started cursing her out. And then her friend like freaked out on my friend freaked out on me. And I'm like, why are you freaking out on me? Sorry. Oh, I have one more story to tell. I'm so sorry. It's gonna be a 6 minute video. 10 minutes. So, this story is actually a story that I can't even with. Because it's really, like, a crazy story. I mean, it's not that crazy, but it's a little crazy. So, this was maybe about a week back, maybe 2 weeks. So, this is a week or two back where I was going over my grandmom's. And I was really hungry, so on the way, me and my mom stopped at Wawa, which, okay, like, that's innocent. I got a chicken noodle soup, Sour Patch Kids, and ice cream. And I went there, and there was this guy who, like, I was just standing there, and I was about to record him. And he started running into the store. Like, he was running, shut out. And he kept on, like, this is him. He's, like, running into the store, staring back, like, looking. Like, he looks like he's running from something. And it just kind of, like, triggered me. I was like, okay, well, maybe he's just, like, running from a friend. Or maybe he's just running. I don't know. So then he stops, like, the second he gets into the store. He's not holding the door for anyone. He just runs into the store. And then I see him go into the back area, and I was about to get my phone out and record him at this point, not at that point. And he's running, and I'm like, what? So he runs and gets like a Sprite or something. I think it's a Sprite. And he's standing at the front desk, like there's a line for people to buy. And he's sitting there, and I see him run out into the store, like run out of the store in the middle, like where there's like two doors, a little entrance for you to walk into the store. He went into that little entrance where it's not the store, where it's like just like little room, like a small room. And he went in there, and then he ran back in, and he grabbed like a box of candy or something, and then he runs back out, and then he goes back into the store, and he keeps on running in and out. And he keeps on like, he looks like he's like confused, like whether or not he should like steal or pay for it, like chance of me getting in trouble or pay. Like he looks like he was very unsure of what he should do. So he runs out of the store, and then he just comes back and he's paying for it. And I was about to tell the Wawa employees, but I was like, hey, at least he paid for it. But he looked like, I saw him like grab like a handful, like, you know, there's like 25-cent candy right there. He looked like he grabbed like a handful and put it in his pocket, and I'm like. And once, like, my sister, it was a few years ago, where there was a line for, like, Cokes, and everyone stole Cokes there. Like, I never stole a Coke there. There was, like, a Coke machine where you could just grab the Coke and walk out. Literally, it was right next to the door. Like, that's a stupid life decision. So my sister grabbed the Coke, got in line, and she's just like, so she's like, okay, let's go. And I'm like, okay. So we walk out of the store. So, that's not a great story, but, you know. So, guys, I hope you like this video of thievery. It's a great story. If you guys want to hear more story times, I have a lot of story times, and this week's videos, Friday to Friday, will be story time kind of videos, and you guys might see some Angel this week, but I will do story times every single day, and I will do vlogs every single day. So my next video that'll be up in a few minutes will be a vlog. That was a yesterday vlog, so I will be posting three videos today. I got to talk about my, today's vlog. So I hope you guys like this video, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye!